Hey, what is up guys? I'm KBHD here, and this is the Bose Quiet Comfort 35, the QC35s. These are the successor to, I guess, pretty much the gold standard for premium noise canceling headphones at this point, which is the Bose QC25. These have obviously, you know, they're red and black, so they got some color wear going on with them, but these have been my go-to for, you know, train rides and flights for the past couple years. So naturally, when you get a successor to them, you kind of have to wonder, you know, what's different about them and are they worth the difference in price? On Amazon right now, the QC25 are $300 and the new QC35 are $350. Now, in a pair of really premium noise canceling headphones, you look for a couple things: build quality, comfort, sound quality, and then of course how good the noise cancellation actually is. Now, build quality is just fine here. It's nearly identical to the QC25s. They're a pretty overall lightweight pair of plastic built headphones, pretty flexible, and that's actually what makes them so comfortable, that they're so light and flexible. And along with the super soft foam on the top band and the super soft leather ear cushions that go over your ears, all of this combines together to make them really comfortable. If anything, the QC35s are just a little bit heavier than the 25s, since there's now a small rechargeable battery in them now, but you probably won't notice that. So wearing these headphones for long periods of time, like a long flight, is still no problem. Comfort is a huge plus for these. Now, since they're wireless, you do have a couple other things to worry about, and those are the controls and battery life. Controls have moved from the inline wire and mic on the QC25s to buttons on the back of the right ear cup here, and they're all the same, so the play pause controls, the volume up and down, skipping tracks, etc. And they're all pretty tactile quality buttons, which is important when you're pressing them blind. And battery life is also top of the line. Now, I've only had these for the past couple days, about the past week or so, but the 20-hour active battery life seems to hold up. Now, every time you turn them on, it tells you when the Bluetooth is paired, and it also gives you the battery percentage of what's left. So when I turn it on, last I had was 63%, so I feel like I could finish out the rest of the week with a lot more heavy listening of these and not have to charge it till the weekend, so that's good. And I feel like if you could listen to a pair of headphones for the entire week and charge it once a week with a lot of heavy listening, you pretty much don't have to think about it that much. So battery life is another strong point with these. Now, sound quality is pretty much exactly the same as the QC25s, which is to say pretty good, but nothing spectacular. It's nothing that's gonna blow your mind at all. It's just like a normal pair of closed back headphones. You aren't buying these to monitor for music production or anything like that. They're obviously very vibrant and colored, and I'd put them on par with other $150 to $300 headphones in terms of clarity and detail. But again, it's wireless, so that's nice, and it actually comes with a wire in the box. On the bottom of these headphones, you have a micro USB charging port on the right ear cup, and yes, you do get that mini cable, and a 3.5mm headphone jack on the left ear cup. And that wire is included to either plug it into something that doesn't have Bluetooth and just listen to them like normal headphones, or plug it in and use the headphones without noise cancellation. So if you just want regular listening with no noise cancellation, you have to do it through the wire, but you can't do it wirelessly. And then the noise cancellation itself, Bose does this pretty much better than anyone else. It's kind of what they're best at. There's microphones, as you can see, all around the outsides of the headphones to pick up outside noise and frequencies and just cancel them out. So if you've heard Bose noise canceling headphones before, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It's great for flights, it's great for loud environments, trains, buses, basically anytime you want to cancel out the outside world and just hear your audio, just listening to your music, isolated. I mean, that's why you buy noise canceling headphones in the first place. So I'm happy to say that Bose has put together a complete package here with the QC35s. They'll be replacing my QC25s. It even has things like NFC built in for quick Bluetooth pairing by tapping it to your Android phone, so that was convenient. And there's the carrying case as well, that's pretty similar to the one the QC25s had, since they fold up the exact same way. Plus, they carry extra cables now, too. And again, that's ideal for traveling and just tossing the headphones in a bag or a backpack or something. And there's the flying adapter, too, since they know that people use these a lot on planes. So coming back to that price difference, basically, if you want to have specifically noise-canceling wireless headphones, then you have to pay the extra $50 to go with the 35s. But if you just want noise-canceling headphones, and you don't really care about the convenience of having no wire, then this is just fine. The 25s are functionally pretty much exactly the same as the QC35s. No wire, slightly shorter battery life, single AAA battery, also has a wire, $50 cheaper for the 25s. that's your breakdown. But bottom line is, if you're looking for noise canceling headphones in general in a premium sort of $300 price range, you should have these on your short list. Either way, that's been it. Thank you for watching. If you have any other suggestions for headphones or audio products or anything else tech related you want me to take a look at, feel free to leave it in the comments section right below that like button. And I'll be down there answering your questions as well. That's been it. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.